Now, Apple just released iOS and iPadOS 13.4, which has a ton of great features in it. And today's video, we are going to review all the great features that are in that release, as well as my favorite feature. Let's get started. What is going on, everyone? It is Mike, and welcome back to Tech 24/7 TV, where we bring you the best in unboxing and product reviews so you can make informed buying decisions. Here on this channel, we do the analysis of the various bits and bytes that transcend technology, only to find their way into your pocket. So if you like feature review videos just like this one, make sure you're subscribed with notifications to be notified when that new content drops. So this is going to allow you to go ahead and customize the settings for tvOS while you're streaming and downloading the content. So go into settings, head down to tvOS, and the first section you see here is going to give you streaming options. So anytime that you're watching, you know, an Apple TV show, you can go ahead and choose to stream it over the cellular network, what quality it's going to be, whether it's going to be high quality or low quality, or just say maybe data saver quality. What's the quality going to be like while you're on cellular? What's the quality going to be like when you're on Wi-Fi downloading it? And what are the default languages? Now you also have the ability to go ahead and set the quality for videos, whether it's going to be HD or SD, down at the very bottom. So truth be told, I am someone who probably overuses Memoji and Emoji stickers just a little bit too often. Yep, that is right, I am that guy. Now to get the Memoji stickers, let's go ahead and open up messages. We are going to go ahead and swipe it up from the bottom here to really get that full screen view. And now we see that there are more stickers like party face, smiling face with hearts, eyes rolling, and huffing with anger. Now let me know in the comments below if you like using Memoji stickers, and if so, what is your favorite sticker to go ahead and use? So this next one is going to be an accessibility feature. You go ahead and click settings, go to accessibility, and then at the bottom it's going to be Siri. Now your phone always knows, or your phone has a sense of what is in the orientation that it is. Now what you can go ahead and do is you can turn this on and your phone will always be listening for you to go ahead and call the assistant. Now this next feature is going to be limited to the iPad. Now this is going to work on any iPad that is running iOS 13.4. So it doesn't matter if you have an iPad Pro, iPad Air, iPad Mini, this is going to go ahead and work across all of them. And this is the ability to go ahead and connect a trackpad or a mouse on your iPad if you're using either the first or second generation Apple trackpad or Apple mouse. You'll need to make sure that your trackpad or your mouse is unpaired or disconnected from your Mac that you're going to be using it with. Now to connect it, you're going to go to settings, go to Bluetooth, and once you turn on your trackpad or mouse, go ahead and put it in the pairing mode, and it should show up there right in the bottom of Bluetooth in the other devices section, and it'll allow you to go ahead and pair it. Now once you have this paired, you can really execute a number of different gestures with this. You can go ahead and scroll up or scroll down by using two fingers. You can swipe up with three fingers to go ahead and bring up App Expose. You can swipe down with three fingers to go ahead and bring up Search. You can navigate in between apps by swiping left or right with three fingers. Now, much like the trackpad and the mouse features, this next feature is going to be limited to the iPad as well. Now, this is going to be the ability to go ahead and change the keyboard modifiers anytime that you're using a hardware keyboard. So what that means is that you'll be able to go ahead and remap any one of the function modifier keys to another function that you want it to be when you're using a hardware keyboard on your iPad. Now, to get to it, you're going to go ahead and click Settings and go to General. And once you're in general, you're going to go to keyboards. And then once in keyboards, the second one from the top saying hardware keyboard, you're going to go ahead and click on modifier keys at the bottom. And there you can go ahead and remap any one of the hardware modifier keys, including caps, control, option, command, and the globe key. So the reason why this is my favorite is really I use Dropbox, I use Gmail or Google Drive, and I really want to go ahead and consolidate and stop paying all these companies different money and use shared folders with, and that is going to be Apple here. So now let's go ahead and turn this on. So if you open up the Files app, go ahead and find any folder that is stored inside of iCloud Drive. And if you go ahead and long press on it, you're going to see there that's going to be the option to go ahead and click Share. So click on Share, and then the second one at the top is going to say Add People. And that's where you're going to get the go ahead and add people dialog. So you can go ahead and add people to this here. Now click on share options file. So it's going to be anyone either that you share the link with or anyone having the link. And you can go ahead and change the visibility to that where they can make changes or they can view only. So let's go ahead and we're going to leave those two options the same. I'm going to click message. I'm going to go ahead and share this with my wife here and click share. And then she's going to get the notification on her device saying that she has a new folder to share with me. So that is going to wrap it up for me, folks. I want to know what's your favorite feature in iOS 13.4. I haven't seen any bugs in my testing since the beta was released, but let me know if you have seen or encountered any bugs. Now, in all seriousness, I need you to be safe. I need to make sure that you're maintaining your social distancing and that you're trying to stay healthy as much as possible. I have a lot of other content in the pipeline, so make sure you are subscribed with notifications to be notified when that content drops. I am Mike, and I will talk to you in the next one.